This is the story side of the tape. If you want to hear the story first, let the tape play, and it will begin in a moment. If you want to do the activities first, fast forward your tape to the end and turn it over. This is the story of Mickey Mouse and Friends' Double Birthday Surprise. You can read along with me in your book. You will know it is time to turn the page when you hear the party horn toot like this. Let's begin now. Mickey woke up bright and early one sunny morning.
I hope Mortie and Ferdie will want to have breakfast with me. It's a very special day today. It's my birthday.
But just as Mickey walked into the kitchen, his nephews were hurrying out the door. Mickey shrugged.
I suppose they have important things to do. I know. I'll give Minnie a call. She'll want to spend this special day with me. I hope she's home.
Minnie picked up the phone right away.
Oh, hi, Mickey. I'm so glad you called. But I can't talk right now. I'm late for a meeting. Goodbye.
Mickey just didn't understand it.
Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it isn't my birthday.
Mickey checked his calendar.
No, I was right. Today is my birthday, all right. But where is everybody going?
Mickey decided to go see his friends Donald and Daisy Duck.
I'll spend my birthday with Donald and Daisy. We'll have a great time.
But when Mickey got to their house, Donald and Daisy were getting ready to leave. Mickey watched as they loaded up their car.
Hi, Donald. What's in the basket?
Well, I, Mickey, Daisy, and I are going on a picnic today. The basket is filled with goodies. We've had this picnic planned for a long time.
Mickey waved as Donald and Daisy drove off.
Have a good time.
But Mickey was even more puzzled than before.
Did everyone just forget about my birthday?
But none of Mickey's friends had forgotten about his birthday. In fact, they were planning a big surprise party for Mickey at Minnie's house. Everyone was there putting up decorations and making snacks. Goofy carried in a tray from the kitchen.
Here are the glasses for the punch, Minnie.
Minnie smiled.
Thank you, Goofy.
The boys blew up big, colorful balloons to hang on the walls. Mortie blew up the biggest one of all.
I hope I don't run out of air before we're through with all these balloons.
Goofy hung up all sorts of balloons and banners across the room.
Gosh, getting ready for a party is almost as much fun as having one. Boy, Mickey is going to be so surprised.
Meanwhile, Mickey had come up with a perfect plan.
I'm not just going to sit around all day. I'll have a party of my very own. I'll invite all my friends to come over. Now, let's see. I'll put up lots of decorations and we'll play games and have cake. I'd better get busy.
So Mickey raced out the door and headed for the store. Mickey strolled up and down each aisle.
Let's see. I need streamers, some balloons, and noisemakers, too. I'd better get some ice cream and all the cake ingredients.
Mickey's cart was filling up.
Now, where are the candles? The birthday cake isn't complete without candles.
Mickey unpacked his bag from the market.
Planning a party is so much fun. Almost as much fun as being at one. I just hope I haven't forgotten anything.
While Mickey was planning his own party, everyone was still busy at Minnie's house getting ready for their surprise party. Mortie helped write a special invitation just for Mickey.
I've got a great idea. Instead of just giving Uncle Mickey his presents, let's send him on a treasure hunt. We'll make him a map.
After Goofy had finished decorating all the walls, he went to work making up games for everyone to play.
Mickey will love this maze game. He'll think it's amazing. Yuck, yuck.
Everything was just about ready. The name cards were in place, the balloons were hung, and the party hats and horns were all set out. Even the punch was made. Minnie nodded.
Well, we're all ready now. Let's call Mickey.
Donald shook his head.
No, not yet. Let's get off to offer this Mickey's presents. Come on, everybody.
And so they all marched out of the room. They were all very excited. It was almost time for the party to start. Mickey was busy getting ready for a party, too. His own party. The cake was almost finished.
This part is the most fun. Now, how shall I decorate the cake?
Then Mickey had a wonderful idea.
I'll draw my own face on the cake. Everyone will be so surprised.
Just then, Mickey's phone rang. It was Minnie.
Hi, Mickey. Could you come over right away?
Well, I'm kind of busy right now, Minnie.
Oh, please, Mickey. Just for a little while.
Okay, Minnie. I'll be right over.
When Mickey walked into Minnie's house, all of his friends jumped out at once.
Surprise!
Happy birthday, Mickey!
Mickey smiled the biggest smile ever.
What a super surprise! I thought you all had other plans today.
Minnie took Mickey by the hand.
Come on, Mickey. We have cake and punch and all kinds of games.
Mortie rushed up and tugged on his uncle's shirt.
Uncle Mickey! Uncle Mickey! We have something for you in the backyard!
Mortie led his uncle outside.
We've hidden your presents, and you have to find them. Here's your map. It's a treasure hunt.
The happy group watched as Mickey searched high and low. Slowly, he uncovered each of their gifts. Mickey took all of his presents inside and opened them.
Thank you all so much. The gifts are wonderful. But now, I have a surprise for all of you. Follow me.
Donald chased after Mickey.
Where are we going? Let's get out of our party.
The whole group followed Mickey right to his house. Goofy gasped as Mickey opened the door.
It's another party. Look at the pretty table and the balloons. What's all this for, Mickey?
Minnie clapped her hands.
Oh, now we can have two birthday parties.
Everyone shouted happily.
Hooray! Happy birthday! M-I-C-K-E-Y!
Thanks, gang. This is just like having two birthdays in 1 year.
Then, with a twinkle in her eye, Minnie turned to Mickey.
We could never forget your birthday, and you made it twice as good with your party.
Mickey just laughed.
Yeah, I guess I wasn't the only one surprised today.
Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy, happy.
that you're extra special. So have a great day.
That was the end of the story. If you would like to do the activities now, fast forward your tape to the end and turn it over.